It is fully under the control of Stability.
Oh, nice, nice, sir. So the I first batch is about to come out, sir. Is it the second batch or first batch?
In fact, second batch just they got the placement. Second batch is also over now. It is already 6 years old, so 7 years.
Yes, sir. I think apart from this win, the state government initiatives, which are different AAAs, it is running, sir. I think it is
those AAAs, madam, are not that much great. Actually, during 15 years back, AAA in Vijayawada, AAA in Srikakulam, AAA that Puluvindila, they were set up.
Yes.
But, you know, they're all based on the, just on the 12th class marks. Yeah, these AAAs, 5 AAAs of Government of India, they have to have a very good rank. In fact, most of the students,
yes, sir, I know.
Just yes, sir, those who don't get IIT, they join these AAAs.
And this one, the AAAT DM, it was functional in IIT Madras campus quite for a long time, sir.
Yes, sir, for three years, it was fully nurtured by the, mentored by the
IIT.
Fourth year onwards, slowly, because small classrooms were started. Last year, they completed the classrooms. And this year, the girls' hostels are fully completed. Now, all the girls are staying within the campus.
Oh, very good, sir. The intake and all, it is, I think, through JEE mains only.
Through JEE mains only. Madam, I was there as I was adjunct professor in AAAT Gwalior from January 2016 to last year June. For 4.5 years, I was adjunct professor. Then, since I shifted to Hyderabad, earlier I was staying in Delhi for 36 years. And then Professor Somaiah Jugaru wanted me to join AAAT Kurnool as adjunct professor. So, last year, July onwards, I'm a agent for Syria.
Oh, very good, sir. Very good, sir. Because I closely work with the IIIT DM and IIT Madras, sir. Because my tenure was in Chennai quite for almost 2.5 decades. So I closely work with those two colleges. So I have a couple of contacts there.
Very nice, madam.
Your specialization, sir?
I did my PhD from IIT Delhi in systems management. I was working in R&D systems in the CSIR lab, Nishtaj lab, joined National Informatics Center. I was in the National Informatics Center under the Government of India, that is in the Ministry of Electronics. I was NIC, when NIC started expanding in 87 to all the districts, that Sheshwari recruited number of people. I shifted from CSIR to NIC and retired in 2018 as a scientist G, Deputy Director General. And
very good.
While working in the government, I became professor in government. There is a Ministry of Personnel. They got one institute to train IAS officers, civil service officers. Is called Ministry of Public Administration. I was a professor which introduced a course called Electronic Governance for the civil service officers, and I was there for some time, then came back to government, then again, so that's how my academic interests were there for the last 20 years.
Sir, I feel you are the right resource person who know the industry as well as the academia, sir. I think we have chosen the right person who can interact with our students, really. Because it is so much of vast experience.
I hope I will make some contribution. So I will start my presentation. Professor Chandrasekhar Garu, I will just, before you introduce me, I will share my presentation screen. Then you can introduce Professor Chandrasekhar
Garu. Deepa, are you ready?
Can I share my screen now?
You can send. No problem, sir.
TCS, sir. Sir, Achok, sorry. Screen chusaranta start
cheyandi. Okay, madam. Okay. Yes, madam. Okay, madam. Sir, you have that upward arrow undi kada sir, press cheyandi sir.
Upward arrow
adu undi kada sir, box then upward arrow.
That's what I'm doing now. Yes, I will share my entry window. Not this one.
Yes, sir. It's coming. One, please be there. Yeah, yes. Yes, sir. It's visible, sir.
Just then I will. Is it visible? My screen is visible. That's yes, innovation.
You can open the presentation and.
Yes, sir. I have opened the presentation. Is it visible now?
No, no, no.
No, sir. It's invisible. I think we have to.
Okay. I will do one thing. I will share the entire screen.
Once again, you share it, sir. Open the PPT and click on the PPT, sir, after sharing.
That's what I will do.
Yes, sir.
Is it visible now?
Not yet, sir. Not yet.
Okay. Just one second.
Keep the PPT open, sir. Then you can, after sharing, you can select it in the window. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now we can see.
Yeah.
Okay. Very good. Very good.
Go for full screen. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now it's right, sir. Now it's right. It's
perfect. Okay.
I think we can start introducing, sir. Yeah, you can start introducing.
Okay. Deepa, please ask the student to introduce sir directly, yes, and then okay, please go ahead.
Yes, Ashwini, can you start, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Good afternoon to one and all. This is G. Ashwini from 3rd ECE SVEC. Today we all have gathered here for the Impact Lecture Session 1, Lecture 2 on Innovation and Entrepreneurship, organized by IAC Institutions Innovation Council of SVEC. Supported by MOE's Ministry of Education Innovation Cell. The speaker of today's session is Professor V. Shivaramakrishnaya Garu, Adjunct Professor, IIITDM, Karnool. Sri Venkateshwara Engineering College was founded in 2007 based on the firm belief that education, especially higher education, which provides a critical pathway to leadership development, economic progress, social and political equality among students. Here in SVEC, students are the first priority, and students are empowered to achieve professional and personal success by providing comprehensive educational experience, critical thinking, and encouraging them in doing the things with great ease and confidence. We are fortunate enough to have an eminent and dynamic principal like Dr. T. Kalpalata Reddy Garu, who is always there for our students and also concerned about the growth of the organization. IAC, Institution Innovation Council, which was started in the year 2018 in our college, supported by MOE, Ministry of Education Innovation Cell, which had and is conducting many events like hackathons and engaging interested students with the projects and many more. This is also helping numerous students in building the interest and zeal towards entrepreneurship. Moving on with the profile of our today's resource person, Dr. Vemurthy Ramakrishnaya Garu, worked as scientist as the National Informatics Center, NIC, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, Government of India, before his superannuation on 30th June 2018. He worked in a research project on the management of R&D groups at CSIR, National Institute of Science, Technology and Development Studies, during 1983 to 1987. He has 36 years of industrial experience in IT and R&D management. Dr. Shivaramakrishnaya sir worked also as a professor of e-governance at the Indian Institute of Public Administration on deputation from NIC for 2 years during 2008 to 2009. He is currently an adjunct faculty at Indian Institute of Information Technology, Design and Manufacturing, IIITDM, Karnool, Andhra Pradesh since 2020. He taught principles and practices of management, software project management, e-governance, communication skills, knowledge management, ethics and human values at ABV IIITM Gwalior as a guest faculty. Dr. Shivaramakrishnaya Garu had done his PhD in management from IIT Delhi in 1990. He takes his pleasure in interacting with student communities and conducting training programs on entrepreneurship. So guys and my fellow mates, hang on every word as I now request Dr. Shivaramakrishnaya Garu to take over the session. Sir, please.
Thank you so much for your nice introduction. dear students and the faculty, it is a great pleasure for me to share my thoughts with you today. At the outset, I am really grateful to Professor Kalpalath Garu, the principal, and Professor Chandrasekhar Rao Garu for extending invitation to me to deliver the talk on the topic innovation and entrepreneurship. Let us start our interaction. I will deliver the talk for about 1 hour, and after that I will have a roughly about 15-20 minutes time for interaction. You can keep your questions at the end. And you know, what is the importance of this innovation and entrepreneurship topic? Why should you have to devote 1 hour with me? What you will gain by spending 1 hour with me? There must be some purpose when Professor Kalpalath Garu has organized this talk.
Sir, our students.
Yes, madam.
Sir, ours actually it's a rural students, and we are nowhere in innovation and entrepreneurship as of now, sir. And we have the initial it was Women's Engineering College, and recently it has got converted into co-education, and we are a long way to go in innovation. So we want the resource persons like you to encourage, motivate, and make our students to become innovators, sir. That's the main objective of this particular session, sir. Thank you.
Very good, madam. Very good. That is a good initiative, madam. I really appreciate, and I shall be happy to share some more talks, some more ideas whenever there is a need. We will interact further, madam, later.
Yes, sir.
Dear students, some of you may be reading Times of India. If you don't read, read at least on Sunday, every Sunday. There is one person who writes one column called Swaminomics. It is nothing about any politics. It is about only on some good insights in the economics happening. He was earlier, for 40 years, he was a managing editor of Economic Times. In those days also, in fact, I've been reading his article for the last 36 years, every Sunday. Yesterday, he wrote some very interesting column. He mentioned in his column, one Indian who started a startup company 6 years back. Name of the startup company is Freshworks. He went to IPO. IPO means initial public share in US. And the moment it went to the US, they launched the IPO. The share of the company got about 580 employees. And out of them, 60 employees are less than 30 years age. That means there are very young people. And each one of them got e-stock. E-stock means every employee got a stock, shares. And the moment it was opened for the public subscription, the price has gone from $37 to $37 to $49 in the US stock market. As a result, that if you are interested, you can read that article, you can get a lot of details. That means every employee has become crorepati. Every employee who had joined even recently, of course, the people who are there for the last 6 years, they got more shares. They have a lot of, that means, people who have some good ideas. If they start, they pursue the innovation, if they become entrepreneur, definitely they can become prosperous. And they, in that process, our country will become more prosperous. You see, about 10 years back, two students of IIT Delhi, Binny Bansal and Ender Bansal, both of the Bansals, they started a company, Flipkart. And in fact, for some time before they started their own organization, they were having that spirit of innovative spirit and entrepreneurial quality in them. They worked for some time in Amazon, and after gaining some knowledge and experience, when they got insights in the Amazon business, these both the friends who were classmates, the Sachin Bansal and Binny Bansal, alumni of IIT Delhi, founded a startup called Flipkart. And that was a huge success. And it was taken over by the global giant Walmart last year. As a result, both these people became billionaires. Now, in that process, our country gained a lot of money. Country wealth has gone up because of these innovators. So we require more and more Sachin Bansal or Vinny Bansals, or this person who started the company startup a few years back, this new company which is becoming very, very, what you call, famous in US. His name is Ganesh Mathurbhutam. This Ganesh Mathurbhutam started, he pursued an idea because, you know, the cloud computing is made a huge impact on the online business or online services, both, even online services. So there is a concept in the cloud computing called SaaS, software as a service. He pursued that business model and he started providing the service to the customers. So he got in these 6 years 40,000 customers, and that's how this Freshworks became a success. So if you are having some good idea, if you are having some innovative spirit in you, you also can become a good entrepreneur. So let us understand, therefore, what is meant by innovation? What is meant by entrepreneurship? In the next 1 hour, I will explain you what are the provisions in new education policy 2020 to promote the innovation and entrepreneurship. Then I will explain you the definition of innovation, the concept of innovation. Then I will briefly explain three innovation categories. Of course, 1 hour is not sufficient to explain all these points. So somewhere I will go speed. That means I will give only broadly some points. Somewhere I will give you more details. So I will give you where India stands in the global innovation index. Are we doing well? Are not doing well? Let us understand our ranking. Then we will try to identify what is meant by creative leadership that is required for the innovation. So then we'll try to understand some of the examples from the foreign and also from our India. Then we will try to understand what is entrepreneurship and how the entrepreneurs can build the nation, what they can do, how they can contribute in nation building. And we will try to understand the three characteristics of the entrepreneurial activity. And if time permits, I will touch the last point. Otherwise, I will skip the last point how the entrepreneurships are established. In fact, that is a separate, I deliver a 1 hour talk on how entrepreneurships are established. So therefore, I may not touch that in full. If time permits, I will just only tell some points. Professor Chandrasekhar Rao Garu, whether the points are clearly visible to you?
Yes, sir. They're visible, sir.
Yes, sir. It is very clear, sir.
Okay, madam. So let us understand I hope the students may be aware of Government of India launched the new education policy last year. About 10 years back, exactly 10 years back in 2011, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, though he was not president at that point of time, since he was an eminent scientist, he was invited by IIT Guwahati as a special guest in their convocation program. And he inspired the students and the faculty. What he mentioned there, that one line, he said that education should create jobs and entrepreneurs. He says that the aim of the education institute is not just teaching. You should be able to create more and more entrepreneurs. In fact, Kalam, some of the books which he wrote, it is really very inspiring. If you read those things, and you will get some good ideas. His own life is a great inspiration for all of us. NEP 2020, new education policy, is aimed at exactly doing what Dr. Kalam told, exactly what Kalam has aimed at in those days 10 years back. NEP 2020, if you really understand all the provisions, it will create jobs and it will make many students as entrepreneurs. That is the aspiration of our country. That's what is put in the NEP 2020 by Kasturi Rangan, a famous scientist who was Director General of ISRO and Secretary of Department of Space, and also later he became, since he was a very eminent scientist, he became Rajya Sabha member, and he was heading the committee of NEP 2020, and this NEP 2020 is a really good document because of the way it was drafted. It was lauded by many, and everybody feels that it will not just an instrument, it is a, so it gives a lot of ideas to make sure that our existing education system will be at par with the advancing world or advanced world both. So let us understand some of the provisions, how NEP will inspire the people. Actually, one of the aim is how to inculcate the spirit of innovation among the students. That is one of the aim. In that process, we can make some students as entrepreneurship. And it says from the schooling system, from the schooling system, that means a child when he enters the school till he pursues higher education, he should not just learn, he should learn how to learn. That is very interesting aspect. Learn how to learn. That means it says you should think critically. Students should made think critically. Students should be trained to think critically and solve the problems using the critical thinking. So that means students have to be trained how to be creative, how to pursue the multidisciplinary aspects of the science, technology, humanities. That means they should know how to innovate, how to adopt the new technologies like artificial intelligence. Or 5 years back or 10 years back, there were no topics like IoT. How to adopt new technologies? Like, for example, 6 years back, there was no EV, electrical vehicle. So you have to adopt the new technologies and absorb those new technologies and improvise them in a novel way. And that's how you have to contribute in a changing scenario. That means the higher education institutes should focus on research and innovation by setting up incubation centers. And like in IIT Delhi, when I was a student, IIT Delhi established an incubation center in 1991. And AAATDM Karnool is going to start incubation center next year. So every higher education institute should focus to start these incubation centers, technology development centers, centers in frontier areas of research. And they should have a good industry academic linkages. For example, AAAAT Karnool has a good linkage with some of the industries to do the research work. They are taking up research projects jointly with Samsung. So every educational institute, particularly the higher education institute, should have a greater industry and academic linkages and pursue the interdisciplinary research. So another aspect, these are the numbers, 11th section and 12th point. 11.12 means section 11 and point 12. It says higher educational institutes will develop specific handholding mechanisms and competitions for promoting innovation among the student communities. Again, very interesting point. So it is driving this policy of new education policy 2020 drives the higher education institutes to become innovation centers by providing the helping hand or hand holding to the students to promote innovation among the student communities. And they have set up a NRF, National Research Foundation, to help the students and the faculty so that you can have a vibrant research and innovation culture across the higher education institutes, research labs, and other research organizations. Therefore, NEP 2020 is a great initiative by the Government of India to promote the innovation. What is meant by innovation? Innovation is possibly best defined as the exploration and exploitation. Exploitation of new ideas in pursuit of competitive advantage. That's what Steve Jobs used to do. He used to explore, but later he used to exploit some of the new ideas. And by exploiting, he used to file the patents. That's where the really, how you can able to contribute to the nation building. I will give you the practical definition or a working definition of innovation. Innovation is the entire process by which an organization generates creative new technology ideas. If you are creating new ideas, new technological ideas, it is innovation. For example, electrical vehicle is invention. By electrical bulb is invention. Computer is a great invention. So you have to have some drive to have a, that means you should have a creative mindset to come up with new novel ideas, technological ideas, which are called innovations. But convert those ideas into usable or useful and viable commercial products. If you are having ideas, but if you are not able to convert that idea into product, then it is not of use. You may file a patent, but you can't really contribute to the economic prosperity of the nation. Similarly, you should have the idea and set up a organization to provide the great services like Infosys, Narayan Murthy, or Ajim Premji. Services is also a big economy. In fact, service sector is contributing huge percentage of our exports. India is doing so well in providing the services to the foreign countries. That's why our economy is doing so well. Novel way of providing the services. The entire banking system in the world is, the services in the banking is driven by the Indian software packages, Pinnacle and the FlexCube. Now, of course, FlexCube has been taken over by the Oracle Financials. So you should also have some type of innovative thinking, not only producing the new products or new services, you should have a new business models, like MGR, new business model of providing the, delivering the products at your home delivery, or Swiggy. This is again new way of, so this is a new business models. So the, all these things will really make huge impact to the nation, economic advantage. It will add to the economic advantage. So there will be economic gain. There are three categories of innovation: radical innovation, evolutionary innovation, disruptive innovation. Radical innovation means you are coming up with an idea which will shake the world, which will shake the world, or which will nobody expected so far, and you are going to expect in a way you are going to set the trend for the world. For example, when Charles Babbage invented the computer, earlier nobody knows how the data can be processed. Now this computer can be used. Now, of course, you can use for a lot of other things, but how the people started using the computer for making the good use of data and coming with a lot of analysis. Now, you may have a computer, and also you have a net because of the DOD, Department of Defense, came up with a good idea of TCP/IP. That's how the ARPANET was created, or later internet was created. But you may have the internet, but and you may have a computer. But if you can't make use of the computer to link with other computers using the internet, what is the use of? That means you can use the computer only for you. You can't share the document with others. That's where the brilliant idea of Timms Burnley, World Wide Web. He was a physicist. He is not a computer scientist. The way he has, because he was having a need, he thought he has to interact, because he is a great famous scientist in the particle physics. But he has a passion. He has a passion to make use of the computer and linking with the other computers and to share the documents with them. So that's how the WWW was invented. So that is called radical innovation. Then you are also having evolutionary. That means you are making some improvements in the products. For example, Maruti Suzuki. Suzuki started in India by collaborating with the government of India. Maruti was earlier, otherwise government. Maruti Suzuki. Of course, now Suzuki got now more than 90% stock. They came up with a small car, Maruti 800, for a long time, for 15 years. That was the only car from the Maruti. Then they started with new technologies. Now, Maruti got so much improvement in their models. Of course, they bring every 6 months, they bring new models, every 6 months. That's how the automobile industry works. If you are not pursuing the evolutionary research, if you are not improvising your automobile model, car model, you will not survive in the market. Your competitors will take over you. That's how the Birlas could not able to stand up to the foreign companies. You know, otherwise, CK Birla product, Hindustan Motors, which was manufacturing the Ambassador, and Ambassador was a great car. That if you are going to the office by Ambassador means you are having a royal treatment in the office, because coming by Ambassador when I joined the government. Because all the offices were provided only the Ambassador, and if you are going by Maruti 800, nobody will salute you. But if you are going by Ambassador, people will salute you. That got such a huge brand image. But the way they could not able to, because they were unable to improvise their product, they could not make any evolutionary innovations. Whereas the Suzuki was making, later Honda was making, and the great Ratan Tata started the Tata Motors were earlier were producing only buses and trucks, but he started the car, Indica. Indica was a great success, not only in India. In fact, you know, in Indica, when it was started, all the Bombay drivers, anyone of you went to Bombay earlier, Bombay drivers, because Bombay there are no autos are available, only cars. And I used to go to Bombay and only Fiat Padmini, small car. But when the Indica was launched, it was such a great success. All the Bombay drivers changed their cars. Of course, they got a huge discount. Tata Motors gave a huge discount. So that's how it became great success, evolutionary. And third model is disruptive. You are already having market for some product, but in that product, if you start adding some type of new, for example, we were having all the computers were having only floppy drives, and there was no concept of flash memory. The moment flash memory came, how is it now for us to carry pen drive to go anywhere and give the presentation? So that is how it is a disruptive technology, flash memory. Or you say electric vehicle, that is again a disruptive technology. So you should be able to pursue all the three categories of innovation. Of course, this is the list of radical innovation in the last 120 years, starting from airplane or air condition 100 years back to the electrical vehicle. 6 years back, it is really great radical innovations throughout the world, and innovation does not happen by itself. It is the result of hard work. You have to plan well. If you want to innovate, you have to plan well. It requires a good research planning. And for some time, I was working in the area of research planning when I was in the CSIR. And you have to execute that plan, research plan, then only some innovation will happen. Otherwise, innovation will not happen on its own. Therefore, you have to plan and you have to put hard work and you have to execute your plan. And you need not to be genius. If you pursue innovation, in fact, innovation itself is a discipline. The innovation is a matter of discipline. As Peter Drucker was a management guru, he wrote 29 books. Till the last day of his life, he died at the age of 92 years. When I was doing PhD in IIT Delhi Library, I read many of his books. He wrote 29 books and I read 15 books, of course, not only from IIT Delhi Library. I was also a member of American Central Library in Delhi. And he used to give very new ideas. He says, innovation is a matter of discipline. If you pursue the discipline, you can become innovative. That means you need not to become a genius. So where India stands innovation? Are we doing well? Are we filing many patents? Are we having good infrastructure in the country? What is our ranking in the Global Innovation Index? So we have to measure how well we are doing. Otherwise, we can't do well unless we measure. So we have to participate in the global survey. That's how India participates. And in the 192 countries which participate in the survey, India ranking, unfortunately, is at 48. Of course, it has improved a little bit. And Switzerland, a small company, its rank is number one. Sweden rank is two. US rank is three. You know, Sweden, all the military, like for example, India, in Rajiv Gandhi time, some of the faculty may be knowing, we purchased the Bofors. Tanks, Bofors are great tanks for the army.
Yes.
And we purchased Bofors from the Sweden.
Yes.
So we spent a huge amount of money. So Sweden earns a lot of money because of their innovations. India is not doing well. Unfortunately, for a thousand years, there is no promotion of innovation in the country. Innovators came to our country, innovators looted, destructed our capability. As a result, there was no patent or no innovation. Then only after 1947, when we started, that means when we achieved independence, Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar, the great scientist, that's how all the awards given by CSIR is known as the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Awards. And he established the labs under the guidance of Nehru. And later, we all other prime ministers also started giving the freedom to the scientists like Homi Bhabha, Vikram Sarabhai. That's how, otherwise, we were nil in the S&T. Only for the last 75 years, we are doing well. Doing well means started doing well, and we have to catch up with these countries. And that is possible only some of our students are going to become scientists, great scientists. So they have to become very creative. What is meant by creative? Creativity is the development of new ideas about products, practices, services. As I mentioned, services also plays an important role. Like Narayan Murthy was very creative to provide the services. So you have to have creativity. You have to come up with new ideas, procedures that are very novel and that are very potentially useful to the growth of your organization. Like Kumar Mangalam Birla or Ratan Tata, they also pursue their ideas and implement the ideas. That's how, you know, even the commercial model of Tata's. In fact, we should say Ratan Tata is as genius as J.R.G. Tata. Friends, in the entire Indian industry, only one industry has got so far in the 75 years, in the last 75 years, Government of India gives every year senior awards. Highest award is Bharat Ratna. Only one industry is called Bharat Ratna. He was the J.R.D. Tata. He was the first pilot of the country. He has the idea how to make use of the aeroplane. He started his own company. In fact, Air India was their own company. The Mrs. Indira Gandhi took over that one. Otherwise, J.R.D. Tata started the European company in the country in 1937. We are the growth of the industry in the country. That's how we became the Bharat Ratna. Same thing with his son, Ratan Tata. He made India as a... See how he has taken Tata Steel to the global. He has acquired the Corus in in UK. And Tata Motors, they acquired Jaguar. JLR and other models. So they are creative people. The way Steve Jobs is a very creative personality, is very charismatic, pioneer of the personal computer, the way he established his lab in a garage of his father, in the garage, with his friend, Steve Wozniak. He started some type of experimentation in his father's garage and then started the Apple computers in 1976. And that has become a great leader in the telecom in the entire world because the way Steve Jobs pursued his ideas and he came up with the revolutionary products like iPod, iPhone, iPad. In fact, though he had a cancer, he knows he is going to die in a few months' time. That's what doctor told him, that you are going to die after a few months. But he, knowing well that he is going to die, he wanted to pursue the research. That's where the creative leaders, some of the leaders, though they know that they are going to be there only for a few months, or like we also have in our India, that the same thing about 5,000 years back, when Parikshit, Maharaja Parikshit was told by one Muni that we are going to die after 7 months. Because of the curse, 7 days, he are going to die after 7 days. And he did not feel anything problem. He thought that, okay, then what contribution I can make to the world in the next 7 days? That's how the entire Mahabhagavatam came. So Parikshit, in the 7 days, the way he pursued his life, same way this creative leader Steve Jobs pursued few months and came up with several patents before his death. That's how he created 300 patents. That is the innovative spirit of the some people like Steve Jobs or see this Nandan Nilekani. He was a great entrepreneur. He pursued his idea along with his friend, senior colleague. They were working together in PCS, Putnam Computer Services. And Narayan Murthy was his boss. When Narayan Murthy came with an idea, he discussed with Nandan, and Nandan was a product of IIT Bombay. And they pursued that idea, and they also involved the other five people. That's how the seven people started the Infosys. The N.R. Narayan Murthy, Nandan Nilekani, Chris Gopalakrishnan, Shivu Lal, K. Dinesh. So these people are all creative leaders. And in particular, this Nandan Nilekani, when he wrote a book, Transforming India, when Manmohan Singh read that one, he called Nandan Nilekani. He, in that book, he mentioned every Indian should be given a unique identity. And it is possible. That's what Nandan Nilekani wrote. And Manmohan Singh told Nandan, why can't you join the government? But that he was a CEO of Infosys at the time. Then he left Infosys for the country's sake. He wanted to make contribution for the country. He, of course, took the advice of the Narayan Murthy. Narayan Murthy also told that, please go ahead with the idea and join. That's how he became cabinet minister with he was the chairman of Unique Development Authority of India, which got the cabinet minister rank for 5 years, and he pursued his idea, and that's how the Aadhaar came up. Each of us are now, without Aadhaar, can we imagine our life? Can we imagine our life?
No. Everything is Aadhaar enabled, sir, now. Yes.
Everything is Aadhaar enabled. Even now, if you go from one city to another city, one state to another state, they say, yes, that have you got the vaccination? They will ask your Aadhaar number, they will verify, or you can carry the certificate. You can go download,
especially the using the direct benefit for the poor man, sir. That is, yes, the most important thing.
Yes, yes, because of the Aadhaar, the poor man got the bank. There is a concept called JAM. JAM, yes, is Jandan Aadhaar using mobile number. So this is a JAM of the this the saw that person who died. That person is this Arun Jaitley coin JAM. Jandan, because a poor man should have a bank account. So using your mobile and Aadhaar, you can open the bank account. That's what Arun Shori came up with the idea, and Modi accepted, and that's how this because of the that was possible because of the great idea of this person, Nandan Nilekani. He is a great creative leader, and of course each one of us know how we are really grateful to the Abdul Kalam. Mrs. Gandhi called him in 1981. There was a post of director of DRDL in Hyderabad. At that time, Kalam was working in Department of Space. And we have to, country has to produce a missile. And the another person, senior scientist of DRDL, was also called. Next person, because that post was vacant, the director retired. The second highest a senior person was also applied, and both of were interviewed by UPSC already, but Mrs. Gandhi also want to interact with them. And the first person of that DRDL told madam, because he was not very confident, he is not very sure, he could not convince Mrs. Gandhi that DRDL can able to make a message. But this person went next, after few minutes he told madam it is possible. Then she asked, Mrs. Indira Gandhi asked, how much time? Madam, you give me 24 months, I will give you the missile. Give me 24 months, I will give you the missile. With one request. Then Mrs. Gandhi asked, what is the request? Madam, I will borrow the people from 5 labs in the country. If I have to develop a missile, I require the genius scientist of 5 labs. He says, what are the 5 labs? Madam, my own Department of Space, we got a scientist in Trivandrum, Vikram Sarabhai Space Center. Because yes, they know the rocket launch, that missile technology depends upon that. And we require the scientist from the explosives lab of the Pune. We require the talent from the Dehradun Defense Electronics Institute. And madam, I want one team is there in Delhi. I want to borrow their help also. She asked, who is that team? The team was headed by one person whom I know very closely. I had the great privilege of making three times. I had the privilege of delivering a talk when he chaired my session. His name is P.V. Indiration. He was the head of the Center for Advanced Research in Electronics Care in IIT Delhi. And Kalam wanted him to be also be part of this missile project. And he delivered the missile project in 24 months. And he made several contributions to the country. He wants India has to be transformed into a developed nation, a prosperous nation. How it is possible? How can he become a prosperous? Only if you can able to pursue the innovation. That means every person, every student of SVEC, every student of SVEC has to understand these two words. You have to make some contribution to make India as a prosperous nation through your innovative spirit. You have to make our country as a developed nation through your innovative spirit with a good value system. You, the Kalam got a great value system. His integrity is of highest order. So you should become another, each student should Because I got my inspiration from the Kalam. Every day I get inspiration. You should also get inspiration. Similarly, this person was my role model. I had the great opportunity of working with this person. Just I will take some water and I will join. Just 1 second. This person was a product of Indian Institute of Science. He completed his PhD in 3 years in computer communication. He was a genius person. At the age of 25 years, he became senior scientist in Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. M.G.K. Menon picked him up. And when M.G.K. Menon became the chairman of the Electronics Commission, Cheshire was asked M.G.K. Menon to come to Delhi, and he went to Delhi and he came up with some new projects. NIC was a project, not an organization at the time. NIC was a project funded by the World Bank, and it was a project for 3 years. And the project was so great, Indira Gandhi was interested the NIC to become an organization, and he rose up to the Secretary of the Government of India, Special Secretary means Secretary of the Government of India, and he established NIC, he established NICNET, and in 1987, when I joined NIC, NICNET was the third largest network in the world. That's how the government network was established. When Narendra Modi has been using the video conferencing for last 1.5 years in the COVID times, to interact with all the chief ministers, it was because of the NICNET. It was because of the video. This person, Sheshagiri, established video conferencing centers, VC studios, in 1996 itself, in all the state capitals. We were providing, the NIC was providing the VC services to all the state governments. That's how Atal Bihari Vajpayee used to interact with the beneficial Lucknow to the VC. And you, all of you know the great visionary scientist of Vikram Sarabhai. The country has produced such a great scientist. Otherwise, there was no, in fact, nothing was there in India in the area of the space. This person,
yes,
he came back from Cambridge when he completed his some research work. World War II came, he came back to India. He could not go back because there were no flights. He pursued the research in the Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. Then later went back to Cambridge to submit the thesis and got the PhD. He could have stayed there, but he has a passion to do, make some contribution to the nation. In fact, his father asked him to, because they were having the largest industry in Gujarat in those days, Ambala Sarabhai. But he told his father, "Father, I have interest to pursue my space, interest in physics." And he advised his father to give the entire industry to his brother, Gautam Sarabhai. See, the person's passion to do, pursue the innovation, passion for pursuing innovation. That's how he made the contribution to the space, contribution to the nuclear development after the death of the Homi Bhabha. He became the chairman of the Atomic Energy Commission. He was heading both the atomic energy as well as the But he pursued innovation. He has combined the fusion of the atomic energy as also the space with a new approach to solve the rail problem. That's how they have set up the nuclear fuel complex. That's how we got now atomic energy in the country. There are several centers in the country, like Tamil Nadu Kalpakkam center is there. Because there was a huge scarcity of the electricity, and we have, so these are the great people. The, if you are having innovative spirit, if you can contribute through your innovation, you can able to create a significant value for the society or the business. You can help in the nation creating new industries, the way Department of Space got several industries. NRSA is again another great DRL, Ahmedabad. New organizations, spurs productivity and economic growth. Innovations can fuel the wealth creation. That's how the America has prospered, because of the great innovative minds in US. America became superpower, and they provide high paying jobs. That's how the Indians go there. As a result, the standard of living in US has gone up, going up every year. So you have to contribute to the nation through your innovation. So innovation is regarded as a priority if countries are emerge from the global crisis. If India has to emerge as a leader, you have to invest in the growth in the area of education, in the area of infrastructure, in the area of research. That's what Government of India is doing. That's how Government of India is funding the, that's how they came up with the NEP 2020. So we have to have innovative origin. We should not feel happy that we have created some innovation and feel satisfied. Suppose if the three great persons of that Nice, what is it, Robert Nice, and Moore, Gordon Moore, and one more person. These are the three people who have, because I read all their books, they have came up with Intel, and Intel started creating new chips. Of course, 286, 386, 486, I have used all of them. Pentium was done by Vinod Dama of University of Science. After he joined in Intel, he contributed for the Pentium chip development. They are not satisfied with innovation at one point of time. They have to pursue the innovation. That's how they are pursuing, they are releasing every year new chips. That's how now we came up with the 11th generation i3, 11th generation i5, i7. So every year they come up with new innovations. So innovation has to be continuous. If you are pursuing innovation, you can become, one day you can establish a company and it can become a successful entrepreneur. So you can come up with new ideas, and you pursue the idea and establish a new business, and that will benefit the nation. So this I will skip, because of course these are the points of the IE, that NEP want to new education policy, aim at improving the teacher quality. It's want to use the tertiary education institutions, and it want to give more autonomy. It want to set up, it want to promote the private universities, entrepreneurial universities. That's how many private universities are coming now. Like in Hyderabad, there is the Tech Mahindra has started Mahindra University. With a lot of focus on the research. All the people there are only PhDs from foreign countries or from IITs. They are all great minds. They are all having entrepreneurial skill in them, and they join Mahindra University. So because government can't do everything. You can't expect government to innovate. They can't set up government labs. They can only encourage the education, and the education institutes have to tie up with the industry. So that means we have to unleash the innovation in the country by creating favorable tax climate, give the tax incentives, help the SME sector, facilitate access to the finance. For example, banks, SIDBI gives a lot of finance to the SMEs for new innovations. IIT Delhi got a program called SIDBI training for the MSME people. I used to go and deliver the talks in every SIDBI training program. SIDBI gives the finance to the SMEs. And the country has to make sure that our scientists who come up with great ideas, they should be encouraged to file the patents, and their intellectual property should be protected. That's where the Government of India has a patent mechanism, and there is a center in Nagpur. So you have to unleash the innovation in the country. You have to, the innovators can play a great role in the economy of the nation through their entrepreneurship. And that's what I've been telling. I will skip some of them. What is meant by entrepreneurship? How much time I have? I have another 20 minutes roughly. That Shanshakar Garu, I think I got another 20 minutes. 10 minutes. Okay. I should yes, do sir. The question answer.
No, sir, 20 minutes, you can go ahead, sir, no issue. Till 4 o'clock.
Okay, okay then. What is an entrepreneurship? Entrepreneurship, how it started? How the concept of entrepreneurship started? But I teach the entrepreneurship in IIT Kannur to the third year students. That's what I've been teaching now for the last 1.5 months. This is a part of EME, that is the entrepreneurship and management function. Entrepreneurship means, the word came from a French word called entrepreneurie. What is the meaning of that word? It means you have to undertake. To undertake. In the context of the innovation, you undertake the innovation, pursue your innovation. Once you got some idea, let the idea take a shape and set up a business, your own business preferably, or tie up with some other organization that is possible. And create a new value in market by utilizing the resources available in the market. Resources are 4 type of categories. What are those 4 resources? What of the material is required to pursue your idea? You require a lot of material. In the case of the car, automobile, you require a lot of components, a lot of steel, a lot of other resources, iron ore. You require human resources. You require talented minds. And they are available in the country. You have to utilize them. You require financial resources, and they are also available. Now the people are coming and funding ideas. Banks are giving the money. So you have to make use of the resources and create a new value. That's what that is exactly the entrepreneurship. That means a person who want to pursue his idea by setting up his own enterprise, own business, going to create a new value in the market by utilizing the resources. Of course, one important aspect here, entrepreneur means he is aiming to be, he has to earn money, he has to earn profit. He's not coming to do some social service. He has to earn the property. That means he is going to sell his idea at a price which gives him some profit. Therefore, he has to create a venture to generate wealth for himself and for the nation in that process. That's what this person, Girish Matrubhutam, has generated wealth for him, created the value for the nation, and in that process, he facilitated 600 employees of his own organization to become wealthy, crorepatis. That's where the entrepreneur can do the wonders. That means entrepreneurs, more and more entrepreneurs means you are going to shape the future of the economy. We are going to start the new business, new ventures like all these great Dhirubhai Ambani or Narayan Murthy or what is that fellow that who started that Ola? Bhavish Agarwal, Ola Cabs. This is Baiju Ravindran, Baijus. They started the ventures, started the business. They became successful. In their process, the wealth of India became more. Our imports are reduced. We are becoming, that's where the concept of our Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, we have to become self-reliant nation, Atmanirbhar Bharat, through the innovation, through the innovators, through the entrepreneurs. Because if you are going to become entrepreneur, if you are going to start new business, if the business is going to be successful, like Infosys, you are getting a lot of tax. Maybe Karnataka is having a lot of revenue. Take, for example, Hyderabad, where I am now living. 50% of the revenue of Telangana comes only from Hyderabad. In fact, when combined Andhra was there, Andhra was doing well because 43% of the revenue used to come only from Hyderabad. 43% of the budget of Andhra, combined Andhra Pradesh. When Andhra and Telangana was divided, Andhra is really having problem because now we don't get any revenue from Hyderabad. Entire revenue go to Telangana and they give huge amount of revenue. Because every company is starting in Hyderabad, like Amazon. Amazon promised to Chandrababu Naidu that they will start in AP. They have an understanding, MOU. But 2 years back, they decided not to set up. They came to Hyderabad and they set up in Anakramguda in Hyderabad. And that Amazon in Hyderabad means lot of revenue to Telangana because Amazon gives lot of jobs and people spends money in Hyderabad. Spending means lot of tax, higher tax with the Telangana. That means the entrepreneur is facilitating the state governments to get more tax revenues. In that process, the entire nation GDP increases, gross domestic product. And as a result, the overall standard of living of the people in a particular state goes up. Because see, for example, Telangana, how it is giving a lot of money to the many people. Because they are getting the money from the all these entrepreneurs, startup companies who are giving a lot of taxes to the Telangana. And government of Telangana is giving the FEBs. FEBs, you know, I don't want to elaborate. But in that process of FEBs, people's standard of living is increasing. And balanced area development, you know. If the entrepreneurs are there only in Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu, in 1960s, all the entrepreneurs were there only in two states, in Maharashtra or Tamil Nadu. That's how the entire belt of Pune and Chinchinwad, all the people used to go there to get the jobs, where all the entrepreneurs are to. But later, Narendra Modi, when he became the chief minister, many entrepreneurs started the companies there. For example, to see the Ratan Tata, how he shifted his entire factory from Singur in West Bengal to the Gujarat, the automobile, because and in that process, like Hyderabad or Bengaluru, because of the IT, now we have got a development throughout the nation because of the entrepreneurs. So there are three characteristics of entrepreneurial activity: innovation, running a business, risk taking. I will go a little bit fast. Innovation, I already explained. Innovation means you have to offer a new product, offer a new technique of existing product, existing service, apply a new technology. For example, when internet was not there, we can't provide a service to a citizen through the computer. When web technology was not there, you can't provide a service. Now the internet is there and all the softwares are using the cloud computing. The cloud computing is also new technology. That's how now there is a one ration card. That concept is now reality for last 1 year. You can go anywhere and you can draw the ration. You can go anywhere, you can draw the money from the bank because all the banks are integrated. There is a network which integrates all the branches. So through innovation, by using the new techniques or technology, or opening a new commercial market, developing a new form of the organization for producing a product or enhancing a product, that's how the Toyota do. Toyota keep on enhancing their products. The Japanese company started giving the tough fight to the GE in America and Ford Motors. Otherwise, only two motors were leading in America, Ford Motors and GE, General Electric, the GE General Motors. But the moment Toyota started giving, because of the quality of their, Japanese are known for their quality products. They see the, how the Koreans are, South Koreans have started producing the TVs, new TVs, new, almost as good as Japanese. So another is you run a business. Innovation means you run a business. Not only coming with innovation, you start a company. You set up a business to make a profit. And in that process, there will be risk. You have to pursue the risk because you know, everybody will not be successful. Element of risk will be there. In fact, in US itself, not in India, in US itself, for every 10 new companies, 4 will be closed after 2 years. 5 will be closed after 3 years. Only 50% of the companies will survive. In the Europe also, the same thing. Of course, statistics vary from country to country. That means there is an element of uncertainty. But don't feel bad. You have to take risk. That's how this, in fact, this person called, this Girish Mathur Gautam got some losses, but he still pursues. So you may have, that means you should take risk. How the entrepreneurships are established? Through the idea generation. Idea generation is a very interesting subject. How to generate ideas, how to pursue your when idea comes to you, and the idea has to be pursued, and in fact you should be capable of generating the new ideas. The way that person, the Steve Jobs pursued. That means you should think of innovative angle. You should, in fact, there is a concept called out-of-box thinking. Then only you can generate ideas. Out-of-box thinking. And of course, how can you generate ideas? Unless you interact with the customers. Try to identify the pain of the customer, where they are feeling pain. How I can use technology to reduce their pain. That's how the many people have come up with new ideas. That means customer needs are to be studied closely, for which you require a good mind. You should have that type of analytical mind. Then you should have a business plan. And the student may have a good ideas, he may generate ideas, but he may not have a good knowledge of business. That's where in BTech, every student should be trained on the entrepreneurship and business functions or managerial functions. What is meant by business? What is meant by management? What is meant by leadership? What is the difference between the management and leadership? How a leader can start a business? How can he come up with a business plan? Unless he come up with a business plan, because he has to prepare a project proposal and submit to a bank or to the venture capitalist, because you require money. And the money comes from the two sources. One source is financial institutions, like IDBI, ICICI Bank, or government banks. The other way is, give your business plan to one of the venture capitalists. For example, some of the Indians are famous for venture capitalists. Kanwal Riki, he is Indian. He's a product of IIT Bombay, and he became a great businessman, and he had a lot of money, and he started funding the new startups. Kanwal Riki, in fact, Kanwal Riki gave a huge fund to the IIT Bombay, his alma mater. That's how IIT Bombay set up a building. I had the fortune to visit that Kanwal Riki building. Kanwal Riki, because they have set up a information technology building. Kanwal Riki Institute of Information Technology. Some building name they named. Kanwal Riki Information Technology Institute that in the IIT Bombay. Similarly, Vinod Gupta in IIT Kharagpur, he got a lot of money. He funds the new startups. Similarly, Ratan Tata, see the great personality of Ratan Tata. He got a lot of money. He could invest in his own companies, or he can invest that money in bank, get issued income. But he take risk. He has invested in money in 10 startup companies. One of the startup company that the CEO, I know him personally. When I used to go to Gwalior, that person used to come to meet the director. Then third is search of resources. Where I can get the talented people? You may have the idea, like our Dr. Sheshagiri got a great idea of establishing the NIC. But he required the great people, talented people. And they were not available in those educational institutes earlier. And he has to pick up. He visited, he personally visited IIT Delhi, IIT Bombay, University of Science, picked up all the PhDs in the area of the mathematics and electronics. There was no computer science in those days. Dr. V.K. Sharma is from the Department of Mathematics in IIT Delhi. Dr. Subramanyam is a friend of Sudha Murthy. Both did M.Tech together in the University of Science. And he was my boss. He was picked up from the University of Science. Like that, search for the resources. To establish a new organization, you require resources. Human resources, apart from the financial resources, which you may get. And creating a management structure, which you require good knowledge of management. How to create a structure there in the organization? See, there are five steps in management. Planning, organizing, staffing, leading, and controlling. Organizing means how I can able to organize my resources, for which there is a concept called chain of command, for which you have to create a structure within the organization, establish a chain of command. That you have to do, you have to create. Then plan for the future. You have to pursue the idea for a long time, not for 1 year or 2 years. You have to pursue the, that means you should have a long-term goals. You come up with long-term goals for the organization. That's what Narayana Murthy did. In fact, one foreign company came to purchase, because Infosys was not making much progress for the first 8 years. And all these six other people were thinking, can we continue? Or because that American company which want to purchase, they gave a very good offer. All the other six people were tempted to sell their shares. So when the board meeting happened, all these six people told Narayana Murthy, sir, I am telling briefly in 1 minute, otherwise it is a big story. Sir, we want to sell our shares to the company which is offering a good amount to us. We want you also to support our idea. Narayana Murthy told, friends, I have a different opinion. I feel Infosys will do very well. Therefore, I will not sell. You go for lunch and come back after 1 hour. If you still want to sell your shares, instead of selling the shares to the partner, American company, you please sell the shares to me. I will purchase. But I am just giving advice. I want to make a request to you. If you want to sell, but I don't want you to sell. I want you to continue. I have a plan for the future of the Infosys. This is a short words he has used, and they went for the meeting was adjourned for lunch, and they had a discussion. Why this person is having a different opinion? Narayana Murthy, why he is not agreeing? That means he want to purchase. That means there is something, he got some good idea. Then they came back and they expressed their sorry. Sir, we are sorry that we hurted your sentiment. We want to stay with you. And within 1 year, Infosys has a huge growth. And Narayana Murthy is a person who is not selfish. He want to grow along with his colleagues. He wanted to see the every one of his colleagues should become prosperous. People must know Narayan Murthy was almost like a Marxist or a socialist in his early days. Of course, now he changed completely. He understood the market economy. When Infosys started, he gave the first company in the country. How he planned for the future of the Infosys? How he planned for the great organization? He said that I am going to offer. Am I audible, Chandrasekhar Rao, sir? Hello?
Sir, you're audible, sir.
Okay, okay. So, this person gave a stock to every employee, including the sweeper, E-stock, first company in the country. As a result, everybody started contributing a lot to the Infosys with all dedication. Even when it went to the IPO, that means they can sell their shares in the stock market, and everybody, by that time, even sweeper was having shares which is having worth of 3 crores. That's what I read in the book, newspapers. Even sweeper got 3 crores worth of shares. That because of the capability to plan for the future of your organization, of course, you have to develop the skill of your colleagues, your own skill. Like Tata's, they develop the skill of their employees, the skill of even the management people. There is a Tata Management Center in Pune. They bring the great management gurus from the US and they train all the general managers every year in Pune, Tata Management Center. So that's how you can sharpen the skill of your employee on the technology and the management. You should be able to see, you have to identify what are the new technologies coming, and you have to adapt those technologies and develop the skills of your employees to adapt those technologies. That's how an entrepreneur can able to continue to sustain the growth of his venture company. I think with this I will stop, madam. I will take one or two questions. I will, if there are one or two questions, I will take. Now it is 4 o'clock.
Students and faculty.
I hope sometime I will come personally to interact with the.
Yes, sir. Your presentation was very thought-provoking, and whomever you are just making it as a note, like Abdul Kalam ji, then the other, the family, Jahangir Baba. So it's really amazing, sir. And I am very happy that I closely work with Vasagam, sir. So you might have heard about him. Padmashri Vasagam Garu.
Yes, madam. Yes, sir. You worked with Kalam.
Yeah, yes, sir. He is a close associate of Kalam, sir. And yes, I closely worked with Vasagam sir in a couple of projects, and yes, he visited our campus also.
Oh, very good, very good.
Yes, sir. Very, so we want you to be at our campus at some time, I think post-COVID, to yes, have ma'am. A personal interaction with the students and have that impact. Yes, the profound knowledge of you should be transferred to our students, sir.
It will be my pleasure, madam, to visit sometime after.
Yes, sir.
Once the COVID situation is, of course, fortunately, in some places, there is, like in Hyderabad, there is a negligible, almost zero COVID case. Hopefully, yes. Tirupati also, there will be no, I don't know what is the Tirupati situation now.
Sir, I think the Tirumala Dasanana is open, sir, now, with yes. The precautionary measures they are doing it. Yes. As it is a pilgrimage center, you are well aware of it, because yes, the whole economic situation.
But I want to visit again, because I visited long time back.
Yes, sir.
So I will come sometime.
We are happy to just give you that service to you, sir. I heartily welcome you for our college sometime.
Okay.
Once I think the situation comes to our control, I will just be in touch with you, sir. So that you can come along with your family, please, you know, visit our campus and visit Lord Balaji also.
Okay. Okay, madam. I am thankful to your offer, and I will two things I can do. One, I can give a talk to your faculty, and then yes. talk to your students. Two talks I will able to do, or at least one talk I will able to do. One.
Sure, sir. Sure. Then because we have two colleges in the same premises, sir, and we have 7,000 students, and predominantly of girl students. Majority 60% are girl students, and your encouragement and your thought provoking lecture will have a lot of impact on their future also, sir.
Okay, madam, thank you. In fact, it is really in that way, it is a good feeling for me to interact with you and all other students and faculty. I will definitely make use of your offer once, and I will come maybe after 2 months, maybe sometime in the December,
sir.
I will come sometime in December.
Yes, sir. We are, as of now, we are functionally working, sir. Physically, we are working. Exams are going on. Okay. And the physical form of classwork is going to commence from end of, I think, the second week. So, anytime after mid of October, it will be appropriate, sir. So, if you please do let me know your comfortable timing so that we can do all arrangements and everything, sir.
Okay, we'll be in touch. I will inform you at least 10 days in advance, whether it is in November or December. I will inform
yes,
you. I will inform.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Chandrasekhar Rao garu, for the arrangement you have made.
Yes, yes. Thank you, sir. Sir, I will present, be there for a vote of thanks. Deepa madam, can you present the vote of thanks, please?
Yes, sir. Sir, to sum it up, this session has taught us that the only way to discover the limits of the possible is to go beyond them into the impossible. So, sir, thank you so much for that. To wrap it up, I, on behalf of Sri Venkateshwara Engineering College, would like to render my words of gratitude. With immense pride and satisfaction, I would like to thank today's resource person, Dr. Vemuri Sivaramakrishnaya Garu, for being so patient, effective, informative, and inspiring. Sir, thank you from the bottom of our hearts for taking out your valuable time and interacting with us. I also take this opportunity to thank our determined management and dynamic principal of SVEC, Dr. T. Kalpalata Reddy, ma'am, for making this possible. Thank you, ma'am and sirs. The dedicated IIC members of SVEC, HODs, and most importantly, our beloved faculty members, thank you very much for the wonderful session. Last but not the least, we would like to thank all the student coordinators and participants for contributing their bit in making this event a very grand success. Thank you, everyone. Have a good day. Until we meet again, happy learning and many more innovations. Thank you.
Thank you, Ashwini. Thank you, Dr. Shobha Rani, who has conveyed greetings. Thank you so much. And thank you, all other students. And it was really great time for me for last 1.5 hours. We have a nice interaction. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Good day, sir. Good day. Thank you.
Good day. Bye, sir.